Good evening, everybody. Tonight we go back to 1970. A little thing that's going on in everyday world. PBS begins broadcasting for the first time ever. The Partridge Family
debuts. Wait a minute. PBS?
PBS.
Public broadcasting?
Yeah.
Because I thought Sesame Street went on the air in 69.
I don't know if it went. They didn't say what channel it came out on or something like that. I don't know. I gotta review my notes.
It's a conspiracy, I tell
you. The Partridge Family debuts on ABC. Monday Night Football also debuts that year. Phil's first car, the Ford Pinto, is introduced. No, I'm just joking. Did you have one? let's see. The Beatles officially break up. Yeah. But they also released Let It Be that year.
Yeah.
And also they record, each one of them records their own solo album and releases that same year. Miles Davis' Bitches Brew is released. Jimi Hendrix and Janis Joplin both pass that year, age 27. Apollo 13 is launched to the moon and is unable to land because their oxygen tank blows. It returns in 6 days. The Kent State shootings were that year, May 4th. The voting age is lowered to 18 that year. Black Sabbath releases its first album. And it is also the first year that Earth Day comes around. And leading into the Grateful Dead, they do a legendary run of shows in February at the Fillmore East, which is probably most of you guys out there have heard. And then in June, they go on the Festival Express up in Canada. And Phil's going to talk to us a little bit about the Festival Express.
Well, it was quite a circus, not just from the standpoint of the musicians and the artists on the train, but that was the year that the people's movement kind of spread to Canada. So at our first shows, there was like riots because. Everybody, there was a bunch of people who thought that everybody should be playing for free for the people. And I think we had to cancel one of the shows, actually, because of that. Because there were just too many people outside, you know, determined to break in. And then once we got past that, it was out across the wide plains of Canada. And we're kind of like locked in this train hurtling through space, and the only thing that saved us was the bar car where everybody would get together and play. And there was some incredible stuff that was played from all those musicians and New Riders, Grateful Dead, the band, Janis, Buddy Guy, yeah. But the high point was when we pulled into a little town in Saskatchewan, I think it was called Saskatoon, because we made them stop the train because we were out of booze. The whole train was dry. So we pull into this, it's probably like just after dark, this little tiny railway platform, not even a building. Just a platform with a sign, you know. And Scully and some other people made a run to the only liquor store in town, because in Canada, they had state liquor stores. You had to buy any hard liquor, and probably beer and wine too, I'm not sure, at the state liquor stores. You couldn't get them in a supermarket or anything like that. So. These guys went in there, and they came back literally with a wagon full of booze, pulling a kind of little wagon full of booze. And they had cleaned out this little state store, is the story. And but the pièce de résistance was a bottle of Canadian Club that was like that tall. It must have held 5 gallons of whiskey. And it came on a stand that rotated, and so you could pour. You know, you didn't have to pick it up to pour. So that was became the centerpiece in the bar car. You know, everybody gathered around that. And at one point, there was a rule that you had to genuflect to the bottle because it was the source of all blessings. And so, and you know, I wish I'd had a video of these name artists kneeling up to them. and some of them wouldn't even use a cup. They would be like. So you can imagine what the rest of the trip turned out to be. And I saw so many people just so out of it. My favorite, though, is Garcia and Rick Danko crawling along the corridor. They couldn't stand up, especially since the train is. So they're crawling along the corridor, like raving at each other. And they come past my little room or my little compartment where I'm trying to read a book. What the hell? And I look out and I see these shapes. And they go past, and I make out that it's Garcia and Danko, and they go up to the end of the corridor, and they turn around and they go back. It's like they were like doing laps or something. Yeah, it was totally crazy, and of course, finally I gave in and knelt to the bottle. And joined in the fun, but that was the last night. And the next morning, oh man, I wish I had a video of everybody who staggered off of that train, or crawled, or fell off of that train. And it was like really hot, really dry, and the really bright sunlight. And as soon as you walk out of the car, it was like ice picks in your head. The life, it was pretty bad. Anyway, we managed to play some pretty good music along the way, and there's a movie about it that has been out for a while. And if you ever get a chance to see it, check out Janice's performance, because she is absolutely transcendental in that film.
So somebody, did they show the whiskey in the film at all?
I think they do. I think there's either a still photograph of it or.
That same year, the Grateful Dead managed to put out two of the most badass albums of all time. In my opinion, some of the best that's ever been put out. First one is Working Man's Dead. That came out in June as well as Festival Express. But then the last one was American Beauty. And I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about American Beauty and
sure.
Working Man's Dead, too. Right around this time, I guess some family members, your father and Jerry's mother, passed around the same time.
Yeah, that was in September. And, it's funny because, Jerry's mom had this bizarre accident where... she was driving in a car, and she had to stop suddenly, and her dog, I think, was in the footwell and under the brake pedal, and she couldn't stop, so she was really injured seriously, and she hung on in the hospital for a really long time, and finally passed right around the same time my dad did while we were doing these sessions. And yeah, she was really good to the Grateful Dead, Ruth was. She sprung for our whole entire first set of amplifiers. In like 1965, because we were still using the Dana Morgan music or whatever it was, loners, kind of, and so she gifted us with our whole set of amplifiers, which is the nicest thing. And but then and then my father was declining severely. He had been operated on for prostate cancer, and it just it was everywhere, and he didn't get it all, of course. And that's the same time that I was working on Box of Rain, and until the song was finished, I didn't really realize I'd been writing it for him, but Hunter did somehow, because he took the music that I gave him and dragged those lyrics out of it in some way, some magical way, and so I would, when I'd go to, I'd drive over to Livermore, where he was living, and I'd practice the song in the car on the way over, and on the way back too. And it kind of helped, helped me to deal with it, even though I could never say the things that are implied in that song to him directly, until after he died, and he came to me in a dream, and we got it all straightened out, which made me very happy.
Right. Well, on that note, they are going to play a very special acoustic set here for you guys.
Right now.
A mini set. And it'll be right up. Thanks, everybody.
was an engineer. So motorboat far and near, coming to buy my guild, sit on the stool, watching everything the engineer would do. And the engineer wanted to buy it too. Left the monkey sitting on the driver's seat. The monkey pulled the throttle open, put the jump, the gunner went 90 miles an hour down the main line run. Big locomotive, right on time. Big locomotive going down the line. Big locomotive number 99. Left the engineer with a worried mind. Called him to the dispatcher on the phone. Told him all about his locomotive was gone. Dispatcher got the wires and copper ready to the right. Cause the monkey got the locomotive sewed up tight. The switch operator got the message in time. So there's a northbound living on that same main line. Open up the switch and going a little through the hole. Cause the monkey got the locomotive under control. Big locomotive right on time. Big locomotive going down the line. Big locomotive number 99. Left the engineer with a worried mind.
Out from Reno, I was trapped by 29. Didn't get to sleep that night till the morning came around. Said I'd run, but I'd take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. To the devil, baby, don't be 20 days. Spend the night in your dark. But the devil caught me there. My $20 bill and it vanished in the air. Said I'll run it, but I take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. I get home before daylight. I just might get some sleep tonight. I got two reasons why I cry away each lonely night. First one named Sweet Anne-Marie. She's my heart. Prison, baby, chance on my tread. And if he catches up with me, I'll spend my life in jail. Got a wife and she no baby, born in Cherokee. This one says she got my chop, and it don't look like me. Said, I'll run, I'm gonna take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. Anybody know? sailor weather down here is so fine.
Friends, they come.
a man could be as poor as me. Take a look at poor Peter. He's lying in pain. Now let's go run and see. Run and see.
Acoustic segment, and we're going to take a short break and we'll be back with a big long set for you.
time. And you know that notion just crossed my mind. Driving that train out of cocaine. Case told you better watch your speed. Trouble ahead, trouble behind. And you know that notion just crossed my mind. Driving that train. Like a dime.
baby, from rolling in your sing. I can give you what you want, but you got to come home with me. I got a hold of that good old love, and I got some more in store. When I get through throwing it all to you, babe, you gotta come back for more. Mama, I'm so hard to handle now, yes I am. My uncle, we were riding down South Colorado, West Texas bound. We stopped over with Santa Fe, happy in the corn, just about halfway. You know, the hottest part of the day. I took the horses up to the stall, went to the barroom. Ordered drinks for all. 2 days in the saddle, you know my body hurt. In midsummer, I took off my shirt. I tried to wash my soul that dusty dirt. With Texas cowboys, they's all around. They get money, but they're loaded down. So soon after payday, don't seem to shame. My uncle, he's out to play the game. I know death, the winner takes the game. Thank you. starts winning. The cowboys got sore. One of them called him, and then two more. Used to not cheating, but now we can be. You're my uncle, he's as honest as me. Yeah, I'm as honest as a dead man can be. One of these cowboys, he starts a job. Let's have him down low, he never saw. Shot me another, that baby won't grow up. In the confusion, might as well grab the gold. Oh yeah, I did it down in Mexico. I love those cowboys, I love the gold. I love my uncle, God rest his soul. Taught the gun though, Lord, it taught me all I know. Taught me so well, I grabbed that gold. And I left his dead ass there by the side of the road. lady come to me, she lands on me this road.
Never ever land.
Come on, come on, come on.
had to die. No, he had to die. He had to die. No, he had to die. He had to die. Well, you know. Spend my life And all my life. To me. Baby, now it's for sure.
the bad now. I asked my family doctor about what I had now. I said, doctor, doctor, you stay in me. Can you tell me what's saving me? And he said, yeah. All you need, all you really need, good loving, and I give me all loving. Everybody have loving. Come on, give me some loving. Come on. Everybody get right. You may be weak, you may be blind. Even a blind man knows that the sun is shining. Even a blind man knows that the sun be shining. So turn it on now, turn on your light. Oh, give me some love, and I gotta have love. I wanna ride your pony and be like Liz. Come on now, give me that loving. Got to have loving. Oh, give me that loving. Got to have loving. Build it up now, baby. Turn on that light and love. Yeah, got to have loving. Oh, give me that loving. Everybody need loving.
Thank you.
trouble all my life.
Thank you. Thank you.
running in the wind and the rain. Wherever he goes, the people all complain.
Another man spills.
at home. Punching up the corner, light up the water, spinning that curious sense of your own. Can you answer? Yes, I can. But what would be the answer to the ends of man?
Thank you.
from my heart. Taking it, baby, torn it apart. You left me standing in the doorway crying, saying your love for me was dying. But come on, baby, baby, please. I'm begging you, baby, down on my knees. Turn on that light, let it shine on me. Turn on that love, let it shine on me. Let it shine on me. Let it shine on me. Yeah, let it shine.
We're moving right along. We've had five of these now. And now we're getting into the 70s, and that'll be a whole different kind of time warp. But I just want to remind you that it's only by the grace of God and Cody that I'm here at all to have this place and the music with you guys.
So I just want to encourage you all to join me in honoring his courage and his generosity of spirit. Just turn to somebody that you love and that loves you. Tell him, hey, if anything ever happens to me, I want to be an organ donor. Believe me, it won't hurt because I won't be there. So God bless you all. Thank you for listening. And well, we got some more for you here.
I see you're doing well.
If you've got a dollar, boys and ladies, on the line. Yeah.
show you how to walk the dog. And if you don't know how to do it, I'll show you how to walk the dog.
Thank you.
little coke at the doggone sin. No can kill my honey. Did. Tell it to me, Drake. Don't let that cocaine be. Cocaine don't kill my honey. Did. Tell it to me, tell it to me.
I kind of miss that goofiness, you know? From fucking 45 years ago. Where'd that go? Okay, let's go through this one more time, as if you don't know who these people are. Russ James on guitar and vocal. Cody Dickinson on drums and washboard. Jason Crosby on keyboards and fiddle. Guitar and vocal. Yo, Scotty Long, guitar and vocal. Alex Koford on drums and vocal. I'm Phil Lesh. Thank you for coming along with us on this kind of interesting journey. So God bless you all. May the four winds blow you safely home. And may God bless this Terrapin Nation.